What's up, guys? Frank here from Metal Injection with the Reaper himself, Mr. William Sadler, known to Bill and Ted's fans as Death. You know, I just saw the movie yesterday. You were one of my favorite parts of Bogus Journey, and now one of my favorite characters in Face the Music. How did it feel to be back on set with everybody in this context? You know, was there a lot of catching up to do?
After this many years, there was a lot of catching up to do. But I have to say, we all have friends that, like, if you don't see them for a long period of time, and when you do see them, it's like no time has passed at all. It's like as if you pick up the conversation right where you left off. Right. That's sort of what it was like with Alex and Keanu. I think it had been like 29 years or something since we saw each other at the premiere for... I did Freak, that's right, with Alex. But I hadn't seen them in ages and ages and ages, aside from the fact that we're all a little older. It was really lovely. It was easy, and it was relaxed, and it was like, dude, how are you? You know, hugs and laughs and... Yeah, a lot of catching up.
The Grim Reaper is very unlike any character that you really get to see you in, you know, throughout your filmography. And of course, it's been 29 years since Bogus Journey. Did you ever think, you know, in that time that you would have to revive this character?
No, I thought Death was gone. I mean, after Bogus Journey, I was sort of expecting there to be a spinoff like Reaper Madness or something. But... And then I got a phone call from Ed Solomon, one of the writers, and he said, like 3 years ago, and he said, I'm working on a script for Bill and Ted 3. Would you still be interested in playing the Grim Reaper? And I said, yeah. And he told me, you know, and then we were sort of back and forth. He was telling, you know, filling me in on his ideas for what the Reaper, where they might be at this point. In time.
Yeah. And, you know, honestly, I think you did the best job at getting back into character. You know, what did it take for you as an actor to pull that out again?
I'm older now. So I get the very I have to say when they put the makeup on, and the makeup took about 3 hours.
That's probably something you didn't miss.
Yeah, that gets, you know, that's tiring. And it was hard on my skin. For some reason, my skin was reacting to the makeup this time in a way that it didn't the first time around. But once the makeup was all on and you put on the robes and I start doing the Czechoslovakian accent, everything was good. And he's just like, and this character just kind of like, he just sort of blossomed out of, it's like I've been keeping him in a box or something all these years, and I finally brought him out to play. I was surprised. I guess I didn't think it was going to be hard to get back into character. But I was surprised at how easy it was, how available this guy was to me, you know. And once he gets going, I can't shut him up. You know, there's the lines in the script, and then there's whatever the hell Death is thinking at the moment. He just keeps talking.
You mentioned like keeping him in a box, you know, and I actually wondered if it was like a character that you kind of just play off the cuff in your daily life, you know, as William Sadler, doing dishes and come out with the accent, you know?
No. I played him. It's funny. Before I did the audition for Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey, a few years before that, I did a sketch comedy show called Assaulted Nuts. I was playing the Reaper in this sketch, and I did that accent.
Well, so, you know, I was actually going to ask about that because I know Assaulted Nuts came out around 1985, and you played it, and it as far as I know, it predates Bill and Ted.
Yeah.
And I wanted to know what was the story behind going from that character in Assaulted Nuts, and how did it get to Bill and Ted?
Well, I for the sketch comedy show, I guess I decided that the Reaper should have a European accent of some kind, a silly accent. So I just grabbed this accent that I had learned from an actor, a there was an actor I worked with back in New York at the Public Theater who was Czechoslovakian. And I did a play with him, and all through the play, everything he said was like that. He would talk like that with this accent, was good. And I just thought it was silly. So I did it for this sketch, you know, where in Assaulted Nuts. And then I didn't think about it again until the audition for Bill and Ted. And I actually called my agents and had them ask the casting people. I said, I'm thinking of doing an accent for the audition. And they said, no, you probably shouldn't do that because, you know, because they don't think Americans can do accents or something. But I did it anyway. And it was funny. It was with that accent, he'd be funny just reading a cereal box, you know. Absolutely. He'd be funny reading the phone book. So I did it and they laughed. But then they thought I was too young. So the casting woman said, Bill, this was like 3 weeks went by. And she called me up again and said, Bill, you have to go to a Halloween store and get some gray and put it in your hair and black out your teeth because you're too young. They think you're too young to play the Reaper, the Grim Reaper. And I thought, well, that's going to look like crap. That's going to look awful. So I called the makeup man from Die Hard 2 that I had just done, Scott Edo. And I told him my problem. And he said, look, I'm in town. Come on over to my kitchen. So I went to his kitchen in Marina Del Rey to his apartment. And he did this age makeup on me where he made me look like believable, camera ready, like 70 years old or something. And I got in my car, drove to Orion's offices, audition again with the accent, which everything was like that. And that was it. I got the job.
So was there a casting call for a Grim Reaper and you basically took your 1985 character to the set?
That's what I did. Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
I think they were looking at Christopher Lloyd, Christopher Lee, you know, the horror film.
Of course, yeah.
Guy, Christopher Lee. I mean, he's the Reaper. He should be 100,000 years old. And scary as hell.
Yeah, you don't look a day over infinite. You know, it's...
Thank you.
No, it's a wonderful well movie. Preserved. You did a wonderful job in the new movie. I think you really kind of bring it all together. And I like the same setup that you had in Bogus Journey where, you know, it starts off this really dark, ominous character and then it brightens the whole movie right away when you start talking, you know.
Thank you. So,
of course, you play bass in Wyld Stallyns, but you play guitar in real life as seen on your YouTube page, you know, playing and singing some killer Irish tunes, in fact. You know, did the fact that you were a musician, did that play a part in getting the role in the first place?
I don't think it did. It helped me to have fun with the bass because I'd never played a bass before, but I've been playing stringed instruments since I was 6 or 7. My dad gave me a ukulele. He played a baritone uke and I played a tenor uke back then. And then he got a guitar. He bought a Gibson acoustic and I got a banjo and we would play together for years when I was growing up on the farm. And we'd play for parties and we'd play for, you know, Christmases and things like that. And then I discovered girls and I bought in 1965 or something, I bought my first electric guitar. It was an Epiphone. And this is the irony of this. I walked into a guitar store in East Aurora, New York. I could have bought Stratocasters, you know, Telecasters. I could have bought any of those things. I bought the Epiphone Sorento, which was has the twin humbucker pickups and the single cutaway semi-hollow body like an ES-335. And that was my guitar. That was my axe. I was in a garage band then all through high school. So, I mean, music has always been there for me. I love it. I love making it. I love, you know, there isn't a day in my life that doesn't have music in it somewhere.
That's amazing. And that makes it a perfect role for you. Of course, it's all about the music.
I'm in the Wyld Stallyns.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. You're in the best band in the world, you know. William, thank you for your time. It was an absolute pleasure to dance with death. And of course, check out Bill and Ted's Face the Music. It's a nostalgic ride. It's heartwarming. And it's a blast from the past and the future. Check it out.
Thanks. My pleasure.